Merry Christmas.
We're live on Christmas, Adam. Time is here.
Hello, I'm Christmas Adam, and I would prefer if you'd all stop standing on me.
We are the Christmas Adam family.
The Adam.
Merry Christmas, Mrs. Adam. I don't even know. That was a terrible lurch.
But... You're going to be lurch?
Brian's no, going to be lurch. He just goes, Rrr. Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
I just sort of thought Brian would be like a Gomez. I've
been told before that if I shave my head, I look like a Uncle Fester. So,
That's my favorite lurch quote, though. He would just go.
I was told if I shave my head, I look like Cousin It.
Mm.
What? What?
We are off to a great start tonight. Off, you look like Fig.
Well, it's been a festive day here at our house. We have been merrily preparing for Christmas.
Do you guys sing songs while you're polishing things?
I listen to my Jingle Bell Rock Pandora station.
Oh. So. It plays all the versions of Jingle Bell Rock?
Do you know how Pandora works?
Sandra Dee to Hall & Oates.
It's all Wayne Newton.
The way Pandora works is it plays the song you put and then something completely different in a completely different genre.
And 10 minutes of commercials.
A while to hold
is
it
this
in.
What you wanted?
Just go from Jingle Bell Rock to, Death
Merle
Metal.
Haggard.
Yeah, Merle Haggard.
Commercials. And then the commercials.
Metallica.
Yeah.
So I listened to that, and I made another batch of cinnamon rolls today, which is probably just about the most Christmassy thing I could have done.
Hmm.
I baked a bunch of cookies. I did. And
you
I didn't, burned.
Wait. How do you bake your cookies?
I take them out of a box, and I put them on a cookie sheet, and I stick them in the oven.
One at a time in a easy bake oven.
Yep.
You notice that I carefully said I baked a bunch of cookies. I didn't say I created cookies from scratch. Uh-huh. I baked them.
I that completed was, the instructions.
You finished them.
On a box of cookies.
That's what I say when I just eat them out of the bag. I made some cookies. I made them appear.
No.
I've assembled the cookies.
I didn't assemble them. I baked
them. He doesn't even frost them or ice them afterwards. Just eats them right off the tray.
Sometimes
just sugar cookies or?
Yes. Yeah. They're frozen. And then you just plop them down on your tray.
And they're so good. I also made snickerdoodles. Apples.
You made them or you baked
I also baked
them.
Snickerdoodles. Uh-huh. But actually, I did fashion the dough into balls and roll it in cinnamon and sugar. So that counts.
That's something. Yeah. I'm down with a snickerdoodle, but the sugar cookies, you got to put something on that.
All right, I'm going to start our not very Christmassy intro, and everybody's job while this plays is to imagine that there's like tinsel
imagine
and holly.
and
sleigh bells.
And bells.
Ready, go.
Some smack, cutting it down like a lumberjack. Come take a ride in my Cadillac. Kicking it live on the radio. Everybody got a right to know. This ain't my first rodeo. Hit spotlight, here we go. Are you ready for the show? 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 So blessed.
Welcome to Christmas Adam Skews. We're so happy that you joined us tonight, that you remembered to join us tonight.
Raise your hand if you just now remembered, because I set a reminder in the Telegram group 4 minutes ago.
Raise your hand if you raise your hand if you're not watching right now.
Raise your hand if you're not here.
Mm-hmm. Well, this Christmas we decided that we would do something a little bit different, and that is have Christmas Eve on a Sunday. Since we decided that Christmas Eve was going to be on a Sunday, we're broadcasting on Christmas Adam, which is a term that until last year or the year before, I didn't even know was a thing. Mm-hmm. But
Ray knows.
Yep. Juan was the first one to say it, and he said it like everybody knew what it was.
I thought everybody knew. Mm-hmm. Well, most everybody's celebrating Festivus, I think, is what's going on.
Right? Yeah.
But we're not doing that here.
Is that on the 23rd?
We're not pagans.
Is Festivus on the 23rd?
I saw everybody posting about it, so I'm just assuming. You know how that goes.
Christmas Eve is tomorrow and Christmas Adam is today. Then what was yesterday?
Christmas God.
Christmas Mary.
Void, I guess. Maybe Christmas.
And it's nothing forest. Comes before that.
It's December 22nd, Brian.
Christmas the deep.
Christmas. Deep Ryan. Christmas. What do they call it? Firmament.
Yeah, Christmas firmament.
Oh, no, we're not going to do that. We're not going to get started with that. We have it was suggested that there are so many Christmas movies, Christmas traditions, and specifically I mentioned the Chevy truck commercial, which has anybody watched it this year?
No.
It's been two full weeks since I mentioned
it. It's very important to all of us.
Yes. Has anybody else watched the Chevy truck commercial have any of you clickers watched the Chevy truck commercial?
Let's just say the premise, because there's a lot of truck commercials.
About a truck that goes home for Christmas?
There's a little.
Wait, let us guess. Can we guess what it is?
Yeah, let's guess the commercial.
Let's guess. So it's about a truck that goes
it's
home
It's got
for
a
Christmas.
Muffler problem.
There's a little girl. There's a little girl involved. I'm almost 100% sure. No?
Nope.
Okay, there's a blind dog.
You know what's funny is I actually created a random tear-jerking Christmas movie generator for the show tonight.
There's a pair of homeless shoes.
Oh, Suzanne thinks it has something to do with dementia.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't do a good job of representing it.
Suzanne. So that's the tear jerker commercial. Is
the truck has red headlights to help Sam. Is that true?
Does it trigger him or?
No. Well, they do.
It only has one headlight. And then it gets pulled over by the police when it tries to go through the snow and gets ticketed.
The Chevy truck commercial.
Looks like you're from way up north, buddy. You think you lost your way?
The Chevy truck commercial does have nobody has seen it except for Suzanne. Okay, it's got a family, and that's all I can say. It's got a family, and the grandmother is sitting off like to the side, and she's clearly out of it. She's not there with them. And then the mom and dad are kind of in the kitchen and they look very sad over at grandma. And then the granddaughter, who's a grown up, she's obviously an older granddaughter, is looking both melancholy and sad, and also like she wants to do something to help bring grandma back for this Christmas event. And so she puts grandma's coat on her, and with the mom cautioning her, now you guys don't be gone too long. You have to be back for dinner. Okay, mom. And out they go to the garage and they uncover their old Chevy square body truck. And they put grandma in the truck and she just sits there. And then the granddaughter backs out of the garage the truck's in pretty good shape. And they start driving around town.
Grandmother, not so much, but the truck is good.
They do not tie her to the roof. That's a different movie.
Do they tie her to the roof?
And they're going around town, and here's the school that you went to, and here's the place where I was born. And the grandma
Brian
starts...
just now realized that he's seen it.
Yeah, I've seen this.
You've seen it and you forgot?
Yes.
It didn't change your life?
No.
I sold all of my vehicles and bought a Chevy truck. I saw it.
Well, I have a Chevy truck, so it's okay. It's already...
because it cured her dementia. By the time they get home from the truck, she's like talking. She remembers everybody. She has been restored. That's the power of a square body truck.
Or it could be the gas fumes coming in from the leak in the engine, or you know, the smell of the engine fumes.
It could be.
You know, Dad, they say that people get a burst of energy right before they die.
She may have died as soon as the commercial ended. I don't know.
Like a rock.
That would have been a different...
She doesn't know how to breathe like a rock.
All right, so let me do this. We do have a gigantic show planned.
That sounded like the plot to Coco, by the way.
We're twinning. Well, tripleting. Me and Juan and the Mastodon are all matching in our garb.
Well, the theme tonight is we're gonna pull on the heartstrings. We're gonna do a tear jerking episode. That was what we decided.
Tissues because... right back here, but I can't reach them, so if I need to,
they're there.
I know where they are.
Well, yes.
All of us were so inspired by that truck commercial, and by all, I mean me, that we decided that we would commit this episode to just pulling on the heartstrings. And so tonight's episode, if a woolly mastodon, a mastodon there on the left wearing the hat. You see it there, Brian, with the hat?
I do. Master Claus.
That is a typical
Willie Masterclass.
Santa Don.
There you go.
Night looks a little like this.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
See
that single tear rolling down the cheek?
One tear.
Single tear.
One sad little tear. Isn't that sad?
One tear.
Has one no friend.
Tear. All right. So let me show you this before we...
I never learned to read.
Because since Juwan already started it.
What did I do?
You were talking about, you're trying to guess what that commercial was about. And I thought, you know, what would be handy would be to have some sort of a device that would allow us to randomly generate.
Yes, crank out the Christmas
movies. And so I made one. And so here we go. Just a
Christmas movie factory.
Christmas tear jerking. Basically, the premise is a tough but fair chef teaches us all about the right things. Huh. So that would be a
Gordon Ramsay.
Is this what you call a? Is this a pastry? Mm-hmm.
Right.
Or
like a hockey puck. I'm trying.
Or if you don't like that. You could have a wealthy girl donates an organ to truth.
Oh.
I want the library to have my kidney. I'm serious. I want this.
I've already wrapped it here. Please take it.
Most of these movies already exist. There's the one about the wandering boy fills hearts with compassion. There's the one about a best friend who marries family.
Ew. Marries the whole family. Wow.
Huh.
All right.
There's the wealthy boy who finds marriage.
Wow, that's a short one.
There's a bashful widow who sees the worth of Christmas.
Uh-huh.
She looks at the price tag of the gift she's been given. $4.99. You didn't take the tag off of this yet.
Is that all Christmas is worth?
I'm just here waiting.
There's the downtrodden ex-husband experiences hope.
Yeah, that doesn't exist.
No.
and a dad marries home cooking.
No, oh, wow.
You know, I've never felt this way about casserole before.
But it's Christmas time.
And I got to tell you, I don't want to live without you.
It's a musical. Yeah. Casserole. Casserole is the ending number.
I give you my heart.
You have so many layers.
A recently divorced ex-wife donates an organ to warmth.
They're trapped warmth. In the woods.
And it's not her. It's not her organ.
So right.
No.
Like, she's got the lungs of her ex, and she just throws them in a fire.
Whoa, no, his liver went up like...
It's a yeah. It's a pipe organ. It's a
oh there you go. Oh yeah, there we go.
Cracking off one key at a time.
She got it in the divorce settlement.
I like that.
Donated it to warmth. A wandering dad surrounds everyone with hope. And we've got the
hope is what he calls his pack of dogs.
Yeah.
It's a dachshund.
By command.
Yeah. A forgetful grandma donates an organ to singing. See.
My spleen.
I don't think it's probably going to come up, but where the forgetful grandma rides around in a truck.
I'm glad of this because there's a serious lack of Christmas organ donating films.
That is true.
That seems to be and a popular one with this random generator.
It's sort of
well, that's the trend this year.
I sort of well up with tears just thinking about it. A frightened ex-wife starts enjoying parents.
I never knew parents were so fun.
Mm-hmm. A bashful grandpa surrenders to optimism.
Oh, that's like up. It's that really is a sad movie.
It's a reluctant. It's a reluctant surrender to it. Like, yeah, all right,
all right, I'll be up.
So many organs.
But he's bashful, so he doesn't complain about it.
He's over there grumbling in the corner. A whole bunch of balloons, like tying them.
His grandpa's grumbling in the corner, and then granddaughter puts him in the Chevy truck.
Puts him in the truck.
And he's like, yeah, I guess so.
A reclusive grandma surrenders to patience. And a bashful mom embraces faith. There's a lot of bashful people in this.
A lot of bashful people.
A young ex-con improves emotion.
Doesn't matter. All of them are enhanced in some way.
That's right.
His anger is a little better.
That's true. So
this kind of like dead
fortitude.
Is this like Dead Poets Society, but with like an ex-con?
Mm-hmm. We are missing the jaded executive, network executive.
Oh,
a young ex-con. Emotionally distant mom improves life.
By staying
enlisted mom improves kindness.
Oh,
Sergeant Mom. It's called Sergeant.
Sergeant, Sergeant Mom is home for the holidays. All right, kids, let me tell you what's going to happen. You're all going to get out there and share.
You're all going to be kind.
Teen is wrapping paper up right now.
If you thought kindness was good before, wait till you see what I did to it.
I like how Tabitha
old grandpa takes charge of respect.
This respect is out of hand. We got to control this respect. Everybody's walking around saying sir and ma'am and doing things for each other. That's out of control.
Sit down, Sergeant.
Take it down a notch.
A drunken vagrant finally learns family.
Ah, there we go. I was wondering where the like homeless person was.
So many years.
He's there.
Excuse me.
It's a shame that he's drunken. Wealthy dad passes along the right things.
401k and
his organ.
Yeah,
we'll do two more here. A greedy chef surrounds everyone with parents.
Well, he kept everything else.
Everything where you surround somebody does sound threatening.
Yes.
It's like that, there was a bunch of kids in his restaurant, so he brought in all the parents to surround them.
But don't you kind of get a little sad thinking about this?
Yeah.
All right, last one. Let's not do greedy.
No, it's life.
Right,
surviving. Yeah. He's barely crawling along the sidewalk.
Thrives. So
I found life.
Man. So there you go.
My heart. That,
I feel like that pretty did a pretty good job of sort of setting the mood for
we
what
we need
got.
Another Christmas movie. We just need to write the ones we just
that's it
for all time. We'll have it.
What do we do? A couple dozen there?
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, Billy would like to feel sad. Well, you go right ahead. This is the show to do it on. guess who's going to be turning a few of those into shorts?
Uh-oh. All right. Jeff's eyes are still dry. We're going to have to pull out the stops.
All right. So
mine are kind of misty. I got misty eyes right now.
Yeah. I've got a little lump in my
surrounding
throat.
People with parents.
I got a lump in my eyes, which is I don't know how that happens.
Somebody needs to donate their eyeballs to Jeff.
Yeah.
I got a lump in my eyes and my throat is moist.
It really is misty.
You don't have to fight it so hard, Jeff.
Just say it's dusty in here. Just say
it's
dusty in here.
It's normal.
Each of us, I believe, has come prepared tonight with a special heartwarming / tear-jerking / sorrow-inducing little bit that we're going to share. And I don't know that we have any particular order. I would be happy to go first, unless somebody else wants to.
You seem the most happiest about yours, though. So I feel like...
most happiest.
I feel like I need to do mine, and that
we
way...
We should save the saddest for last.
Oh,
yeah,
well, mine,
that's a good idea.
We talked a long time about whether or not we would require those of you watching to actually sign an affidavit that says, I do have tissue paper nearby. I do have tissues. Because this is good. There we go. Ray's got her tissues.
Okay.
We were talking about not even letting people watch unless they actually had tissues. So
you got to prepare.
I don't care. Juan, do you want to go first?
Yeah, let's go ahead. I have to. Okay. I don't have to do. I just have to press play on my. I got.
What do
music.
You need us to do?
I got music. Right.
You pull it up?
Yeah, go ahead and pull it up. So here we go. This is a commercial.
Okay. Oh, do you want me to put you? Do you want me to put you full screen with it?
No, yes. I'm off.
No.
Okay. There we go. You've hardly slowed down this December. Oh, here we go. One day you'll look back and wonder where the time has gone. Where has the time gone? The kids don't wake up early on Christmas like they used to. They ask questions like, where's the milk? When it's literally the biggest thing in the refrigerator. Your husband just watches football. Wait, no, now it's Norwegian doubles fjord boarding. But hey, it's your family, and they really are the best. Except when no one hears you tell them to close the door, and the cat gets out and hides under a running lawnmower. But you love them just the same, even in the ups and downs. And you're not going to let time... And you're not going to let... What am I saying? And you're not going to let time get away from you. That's when you decide to stop worrying, take life at it as it comes, and buy things. So remember, when life begins to rush past you, put on some comfortable shoes, and buy things.
Is that it?
Yeah, sorry, that's the commercial.
Yeah.
Just reminding you what's important this holiday season. So.
I like that family with the
the
AI-generated faces. I was not expecting that from you.
I think that was a Photoshop situation where they tried to they did the filter. You know, we tried to improve. I'll pull it back up again.
I'm glad you went first, and I'll tell you why.
Oh.
Because with tonight's theme and with all of the emotions and the heartfelt sentiments, there was a danger that we would forget that Christmas is about buying stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And so I do appreciate the reminder. because sometimes we forget. Sometimes we get all wrapped up in our emotions. We get wrapped up in family. We get wrapped up in the memories, and we forget to buy things.
Yeah. How many times have you been at the tree on Christmas morning and went,
Oh, no.
We were hugging. I'm trying to remember. Let's go back. Let's retrace our steps here. We were hugging. We ate food. We sang carols.
We caroled.
Somewhere along the line, I swear I should have bought something, but
how'd we forget to buy stuff?
We forget to buy.
How'd we forget about the commercialism?
So, yeah, so you're welcome, everybody.
Thank you.
Well, truly matters. Thank you.
That's why we do this on Christmas, Adam, because you got all day tomorrow. I'm sure there's plenty of places stuff you can buy.
Putting the presents back in Christmas. I like it.
Let's put the presents back in Christmas.
I like that.
Mm-hmm. Gimme.
I feel like that has waned since I was a child. All right. So, Peach, do you have a video that you're gonna show?
It's actually kind of very short film, a documentary.
You have two videos, don't you? Aren't you? Don't you have?
Which would you rather see, the one you've already seen or the documentary? I already have the documentary pulled up.
I don't care. You're the producer. Well, if you got the documentary pulled up, then you can go ahead and show that.
I feel like probably the one I showed you earlier would be better for the show, but for the order of the show.
It is pretty tear-jerking. Both of them are tear-jerking, but go ahead. Whatever one you
feel. Okay, hang on. Let me do this. And this. Okay, yeah, we can do this. It'll be fine. This will work. It'll be fine.
It's good.
I'm going to jump on Amazon right now and order some stuff.
Oh, yeah. I can pull up both of them at the same time. You see that? Look, I got all these videos lined up now.
Yeah, well, I can pull some stuff off the stage, too, if that'll help.
What are the odds? If you guys rush and get on Amazon right now, you're going to get something tomorrow, you think?
No.
Juan, can you take your screen
off? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Sorry, from Juan. We have a big warehouse in Indianapolis, so we can get stuff.
All right. So this was
Legos and stuff. Oh,
yeah.
This was some real life sweetness from earlier today. Actual.
I don't know if I'm going to be able to handle this. What do I need to do to prepare?
This is unscripted and unstaged.
Just go ahead and start crying now.
Okay. I was in the kitchen making my cinnamon rolls when I heard the noise. There was just a general noise in the background. And then I was like, wait a minute. This feels somewhat choreographed and arranged. And then this is what I walked into.
You started that. On, wait, start. Get this countdown ready.
They don't mind me.
They look over at me and realize I was recording.
She wants to do the harmony.
Just a reprise. Nailed it. Nailed it.
They didn't squeak once. I can't play a recorder without it going.
Well, like there are a couple of things I liked about that. I like the spontaneity of it, the fact that they just sort of did it on their own. And then I like the fact that both of them, it was a little hard to see because the video is small. But if you were to look at the video and you could see it, you would notice that both of them are wearing their neck straps. So the recorders are actually passing around. They're not just freehanding them. They're not just, no, they've got them.
I've never heard of that.
Yes.
So the recorders have neck straps.
Yeah, like a saxophone.
The only thing I can think of is a saxophone.
Yeah. That's
the only thing that would have.
And both of them. Both of them had their neck straps on. So.
Well, it warmed my heart.
No, it's awesome. It's fantastic. Yeah. If I could have that last note on loop for like 10 hours.
It actually did go longer than what I kept in the video. They held it a while.
That's very hard. So they busted it out.
At one point, Colin, I hear Cammy screaming, Colin, stop it! Stop it! Because they were fighting all morning. And it was like, he was going, just as rapidly as he could.
Oh,
and
that's just that chaos. Sandstorm or whatever, isn't it?
Well, he was just making noise with it. Okay. He wasn't even playing music. So for a long time, I was tuning it out completely because he was using it like a whistle and just annoying everybody with it. And then she got hers out at some point. And then, like, after a while, I was like, wait a minute. Is that harmony?
What is going on? Playing together.
I went, Luke got home around that time, and I was like, are you hearing our kids right now? And so I got my video recorder out and took that.
You're what now? Did you get a camcorder? Or?
Video recorder.
What, in your
my
phone?
Phone.
Oh, okay.
It's like the audio recorder that they're playing, except it's video.
Right. I didn't want people to be like, we want to see the video of you playing along with them with your recorder, because that's not the recorder I meant. So I was trying to distinguish.
Right. Got it. I see it. I got it now.
You guys should all get a recorder. All of you McKinney should have your own recorder, and you should totally have a...
That would be the kind of instrument that we would play, because we've got Andrew playing his ocarina, we've got you with your harmonica, we've got my kids with their recorders. Those are the sorts of musicians we are.
Woodwinds.
That sounds like a Branson, Missouri show.
Yep.
Yeah.
Move over, Duttons.
Yep.
Here come the Branyans.
And then, like, yesterday, or earlier today, they were also playing the bottom of one of those big tin like tubs that popcorn comes in.
So
they flip that over and they were banging on that.
Even better.
Yep. Does anyone ever eat that popcorn?
Yes. It was caramel. Okay. And it was amazing.
Okay.
And there's normally cheese.
There's usually like, one wedge is like caramel, one's cheese, and then one's just buttered,
regular popcorn. And then one is all the unpopped kernels. They're like hard and burned.
I eat all the popcorn after, let's see, it goes fudge, cookies, M&Ms, and then like chocolate chip cookies, and then the popcorn. When there's absolutely...
And then diabetic coma.
Yeah.
You said fudge, cookies, and then chocolate chip cookies. So they don't count as cookies?
I think at first I have no discretion. If it's round... and it appears to be covered in sugar, I think I'll eat it. But then it gets a little more, distinct. I'm like, I need chocolate chip cookies. And then when it looks like an absolutely, and then I'll eat peppermints and Jolly Ranchers and then like Halloween candy that's left over and then the popcorn. There's like nothing sweet left in the house. I may eat a couple of apples and then the popcorn. Go. I was like, is this all we got?
After the Halloween candy, he'll eat an apple before he gets to the popcorn.
But I'll eat the popcorn. That's the point I was trying to make. I will eat it.
You'll get there eventually.
We'll get there.
But fudge goes first, okay.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. All right. Mandy's the opposite. Mandy will eat the cheese ball first, and then the... You would eat the popcorn before you would eat the fudge.
I don't really like popcorn by itself. Like, just microwave popcorn, I don't really eat.
You have to pop it first.
Right. And I don't really like it because my kids ask for it every time we watch movies, and they will eat. Like, they'll split several bags just.
What is the deal with popcorn? You can eat at least a garbage bag full of it, and it doesn't feel like it does anything to you. I do not get full on popcorn.
That's because it's mostly air. Air. Yeah.
It depends on the popcorn.
Salted air.
If it's just popcorn that's not popped, you would definitely get full.
We had some kettle chips here this week that were really good.
Just don't go anywhere where it's really warm right now, otherwise... It'd be like a Jiffy Pop.
All right.
I think you can't find a better popcorn than cheese popcorn. Like the cheese popcorn that has the artificial orange color to it so that you know that it's cheese flavored.
So, yeah. That's the authenticity of it.
I'm going to say Gruyere. A little bit of Gruyere on it.
This is getting dangerously close to enjoyable.
Okay,
and we're talking about food and nobody's going to cry over it.
Okay, let's get back to some sadness. Let's get back to melancholy. Do you want to do your other thing then, Peach?
Or
should Brian do his
thing? It's up to you. What should we do?
Okay. You can do it.
Go for it.
Well, I have this documentary also. And hopefully you can hear it.
Jose.
I hope we can hear it. I'll be really sad.
It needs to be set up. Is there some...
I think hopefully the story speaks for itself.
Okay.
But I am going to... I am going to pause it in the middle and give us a small break.
An intermission?
Emotional upheaval.
Okay.
Try not to get too lost.
Sobbing heaves. Sobs.
Pay attention, but don't forget that we are, get grounded and hold on to something solid. Okay, here we go.
Grab someone's hand you love.
Oh,
it's a Santa sock.
I can't do it.
I can handle it.
Oh, what are we gonna see?
Oh, it's one sock.
Oh,
it's
no.
One sock. It's not just two socks.
Oh, I know. I know what's going to happen, and I do not want to see it.
Oh, no.
All right, turn it off. Turn it off.
No, not. Hang on. Hold on.
Those socks found each other.
I know what's going to happen.
They're all pairing up. They all meant for each other. They were made for each other.
But the ho-ho doesn't have a mate.
Oh, no.
Oh.
No, don't throw it away.
You can't throw that sock away. You can't throw
that
away.
Oh.
It's going into the bucket of...
Oh,
it sucks to be alone. It does. Santa sock.
That sock is all alone on Christmas. And look at how your family just goes about their business.
There's a dance party, and he's all.
Oh, look how time is passing. It's dark now.
All right. I'm going to pause there for just a second.
I don't know. I can't end here. There's got to be more.
We can take a breather. I know it's heavy. Days have passed. Our lonely protagonist begins to fear he will never catch a glimpse of the world outside the bucket again. What will become of him? How much longer will he languish in isolation?
The only relief I've felt... Oh, sorry.
No. I want to hear your...
The only relief I've felt was in the bucket... are a lot of socks like him. So he's with the outcast. So he's found community there, but still.
But Juan, did you see, no, he didn't blend in with the others, and they weren't accepting of him.
There are no other socks like him. That's why he's in the bucket.
No soulmate.
Right.
So he's
unmatched.
We will resume our story on Christmas Day as a young child is playing with her new ball. Don't worry about her face. She just likes to play on the trampoline with her siblings. She's fine.
Defects. Defects.
Don't worry about her face.
Okay, a little bit of joy here. That brought us back from the... What is that?
Oh. And she runs off camera. She runs out of frame.
She knew. She remembered. She could have forgotten.
Oh.
That's the theme right that there. Is... We need to play that all Christmas. There we go. I needed to hear it loop again.
Mm-hmm.
They're matched. Beautiful.
Oh. Yep.
Merry Christmas, Power
Director. Wow. I hope you release that, because that is phenomenal. That there's nothing I could possibly do better in my whole life than what you created there.
Yeah, better than a lot of Hallmark plots.
Yep, that was amazing.
Just tell in real life. That's all it is. The secret to really good filmmaking is you just show the true emotion of being a, you know, mismatched sock.
My order from least to greatest of things that make me sad: lost puppies,
mm-hmm.
Lost children, and then orphaned socks at the very top of the heap. So if you've got, like, if you've got a child who lost his puppy and is only wearing one sock,
on the puppy, ooh, that's not even fair.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Mm-hmm.
And if the dog has three legs, he's only got a sock.
Little brother. it keeps scraping along. All right. So I have a...
Wait. Pause, though. Juan, I know, recognized the music. Did
I recognize
the
music. Oh, that's why I was laughing.
Yeah, I laughed too. It was that whole, almost like a whole episode of that. Or it was...
You hear something dumb is the other day, I think JT brought this up. I think the first couple of notes, I don't know if you know what a pickup note is,
mm-hmm.
but it's before the measure actually starts with ba-da-da-da-da, ba-da-da-da-da. So that's where the measure actually starts. So I think I figured it out. Hang on a second.
It actually has a pickup note in his fridge. So
you're going to open your refrigerator?
Well, the thing about my video editing software is that you can add music, but most of it costs money. You have to get the full version and pay to, you know, subscribe in order to get it. So I had two downloaded sound bites on my phone that I could use for free.
I thought that was a deliberate troll.
Well, it ended up working out. But
now you owe Samsung. Your royalties. Right. This video goes viral.
Well, you had a picture of the wife carrying thing in your commercial.
Yep, your commercial.
Those are all stock photos. So.
Yeah, that music does make me sad.
Yep.
Okay, I have a tear-jerking thing, and for reals, you guys need to prepare yourselves, because I'm not going to take a break in the middle.
Does somebody have like a bad dad joke or something that can...
This is... There's no reprieve on this one.
I don't know if you can hear my five, almost six-year-old in the background crying very hysterically.
It's beginning to sound a lot like Christmas.
He hasn't even seen my video yet, and he's already
maybe
crying.
His dad's out there watching it, it impacted him.
That's what I'm saying, is you could just tell him, hey, everybody has a sock that they're going to be matched with. It's okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. Here we go. You've been warned. It was almost Christmas time,
And there I stood in another line, trying to buy that last gift or two, while outside the north wind blew. Suddenly in front of me was this little boy who positively looked like he'd come from a barber chair, where a blender was used to cut his hair. Seriously, way beyond any help of a comb, like a camel had licked his dome. And when it came his time to pay, I couldn't believe what I heard him say. Sir, I want to buy this hat to cover up my head. It's Christmas time, this hat will hide my shame. Could you hurry, sir? I don't have a lot of time. You see, I've had this cut for just a while, but I can tell it's not my style. I don't want to look stupid when I go out on Christmas night. He counted pennies for what seemed like years. The cashier said, son, we take debit here. Searched his pockets frantically, then he turned and looked at me. He said, I can't celebrate peace and hope because I look like such a dope. Sir, if I don't get this hat to use, then this Christmas I'll turn to booze. So I laid the money down. The kid did look like a clown. Then he said to me with tear-stained cheeks, now I don't look like a freak. Sir, I want to buy this hat because my hair's a sight. If mama sees me, she may die of fright. Could you hurry, sir, and don't bother with the bag? You see, I'm gonna wear it out the door, so I'll stop being an eyesore. You're kind of saved my dignity on this wonderful Christmas night.
That kid, he got a hat. He got his hat.
Oh, he did. He did get a hat.
That was some pretty good production too. I was like, did you have T-Pain on there with you? Or?
you know who inspired me for that production?
T-Pain.
Juan DeVivo.
Oh. All right.
That's the way Juan DeVivo puts a video together.
Be an inspiration if I can.
Well, you remember how we talked a few weeks ago about just writing songs? Remember how we talked about doing all songs about hats?
It sounds like you're trying to say you're taking a swig of bubbles.
Yep.
There was one rhyme right at the end where it's like something about a bag and it didn't fit at all. You just like put it in this bag.
Nope. Well, you know, the thing about Christmas shoes is they just jam all sorts of words in there and don't really worry too much about.
Listen to it long enough. Same thing with butterfly kisses. It's not me singing.
Butterfly kisses and Christmas shoes.
Oh, somebody needs to match those up. That would be the best.
Right. I'm not going to get
tear jerking song of all time.
Butterfly kisses.
Jeff Lane. We're not going to get fined by YouTube, but we're going to ask people to pay us to stop.
That's right.
Right. That's where we make the money.
It's the new Rick Roll, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
Stick it in every video.
Christmas hat. All right. All right.
That's the other part, is hat in so hard. Does it roll? I'm going to buy this hat. You can't even hold it.
That's what I love about it. It doesn't fit anywhere.
Yeah, but the original has a one-syllable word there.
Well, shoes you can hold out. I guess you could say hat.
You can. You can hold out any vowel.
Ladies and gentlemen, Peter Griffin.
I need that in Peter Griffin's voice.
I will.
I need my Christmas.
It would have been more like you if you had changed it to "Sir, this hat I would like to buy," or something. That's how you would have to butcher it in order to be in the same vein.
I like. Can I buy this hat,
ma'am? This is the hat I would like to buy.
Nope, it's funny. I had to start like 3 or 4 times, because every time I said, "Sir, I want to buy this hat," it made me laugh. So.
I can, on some of them too, you're like, you do like a in between. You're kind of like trying to get the lines
out.
It's
terrible. Yeah, it's really terrible. But it worked for Christmas shoes. So. I know.
Crossing our fingers on this one. It's gonna make you millions.
Brian, make us sad.
You know, it's interesting that you went ahead with that before me, because I wish I had some sad music to explain this to you, because I had this great plan for all these videos and these funny but tear-jerking things that I was going to do, and they weren't able to come together because this year it's been a rough year. So many things have gone wrong. I haven't been able to enjoy holiday treats like Juan because I've gone vegan. And if that doesn't make you cry, I don't know. I was all set to go ahead and bring these things. And I had this whole festive outfit, and I have my hedgy Christmas shirt. And I went out and I was ready for the big show, but I fell asleep. And I couldn't quite get to where I needed to go, and the stores were closed. And so then I didn't want to show up all disheveled, and I was going to go get a haircut. And they were closing, and I said, "Please, please, I need a haircut." And they said, "You don't have any hair, really." And I said, "Yes, but it's for SKUs and the children and the lady in the Chevy truck." And they hurried along, and they said, "Get in here," and they just did a really quick job of it, and you can see most of the hair is gone now. And I said, "I don't know what to do." And I said, "You know what, I'd like to buy a Christmas hat, but I don't have any money." And then out of the kindness of their heart, a stranger overheard this month-long problem that I had, because they wouldn't let me leave for months. I worked tirelessly to try to pay off this horrible haircut. And out of the kindness of their heart, someone came along with a Christmas hat, which will probably be the final Christmas hat.
Oh my gosh.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
And...
can we get a full screen on it?
They saved me. They saved Christmas.
Is that a Shriner turkey?
It is.
Yes.
So, Amber, for those who are wondering who saved Christmas this year, it is Amber. And I just want to say thank you, Amber, out of the kindness of your heart, for saving me from that awful, awful hair salon. And finding me a Christmas hat to wear. Now, I can go celebrate with the rest of my family and not look out of place.
That is... I think I speak for all of us when I say That is what Christmas is all about. That.
Hats.
Yep.
Hats is what Christmas is all about.
Yep. Okay. I think the only thing that could have made it better is an adult granddaughter to drive us around the block a few times.
Oh.
We don't have any adult granddaughters. But but we do have a one final version of it's not ready to go yet.
That's an official Thanksgiving hat too, Brian. That's like something you have to wear if you go see any family on Thanksgiving.
I like that it doesn't even fit in the frame unless his head is completely out.
I like that too.
Wait a second. Are you saying you don't want to see Brian's face?
I know. I can. Let's see. Let's zoom out. There we go.
I like how dominant its presence is.
I like how it's too big for this show. What's missing? The tear jerking Christmas Adam version. We have just enough time.
Has a hat.
It's what?
I like that the hat has a hat.
Yep, that is beautiful.
Pretty great. It also has sunglasses.
That's how bad his haircut was.
Over its chest.
It actually took two hats to cover it up.
Yep. So, and it's got sunglasses, so it's cool, and it's got the little fez, so it doesn't. But it doesn't really take itself too seriously.
It fixed it all.
Yeah, it's the hat has a hat. All right, so we've got a few minutes left. If you can compose yourselves to pay attention
here.
How
can we possibly take any more? I don't understand how we have any emotions left.
Now, I will tell you, these are not necessarily Christmas movies, but these are among the top 50 tear-jerking movies. So they're not necessarily Christmas movies, but these are all tear-jerkers.
Sad.
All right, so here we go. Here's a... you have to know what is missing from this picture.
That's Lurch from he's behind her. That's the tallest man in the world. Samuel Adams.
Samuel Adams.
Oh no, this is a real estate picture. This is like two.
That's right.
No way is it Edward Scissorhands.
Yeah.
That's supposed to be a tearjerker?
It's Terminator 3.
It is. It ends sad.
It is. Edward Scissorhands.
It ends sad. He's up in the castle remembering Winona Ryder and making ice sculptures. And she's an old lady.
Right. That is a tear-jerking movie. Have you never seen it?
I have seen it, but I guess I don't remember how it ends. I just remember him hedge clipping.
His hands made of scissors.
He's sad through the whole movie. He's just sad, sad, sad.
But look how not sad she is.
That's when things were good and then things turned bad. When's the last time you saw this?
It was made for TV or edited for TV when I was a kid. Yeah.
Right. They edited out of the sad parts.
Probably.
So here's another tearjerker.
That's Roadkill. Yeah, that's when you have it's a deer that this community raised from just a little fawn, and they released him into the wild, and right as he approached this street, he got hit by a car, and they're all that's the sad part. It's very sad.
And the fawn's name was Forrest Gump.
You have seen this?
Young.
Forrest Gump with long beard and did he have the smiley? No, he didn't have the have a nice day. Mm-hmm. That's later. He gets mud on his face. And wives and goes, have a nice day.
Forrest Gump with a long beard.
I was trying to remember what his hat said.
This is this is pretty close to where he decides he's just going to stop walking, and he just turns around and...
Okay, I'm done running now.
Bubblegum Shrimp Company, the most mediocre seafood you can find anywhere. Hmm. Not as good as Red Lobster.
At least it's not bubblegum shrimp.
Bubblegum shrimp.
Shrimp bubble, right. That'd be
juicy fruit.
Oh yeah,
juicy fruit. Mm. I can even tell you the gum.
It's not a crack pipe.
Nope.
You could say that that's gum that's hidden, that's missing in the.
It's a really. He's but, got a hand buzzer, but he's doing it the wrong way. He's holding it out to him.
Yeah.
Like, hey, you wanna
push that button?
You ever try a hand buzzer?
Hey, Chief. Just jump up and put her in the basket, Chief.
I had to read this book in college before I watched the movie.
Yeah. One of my favorite movies.
Is it?
I love this movie.
That one doesn't end well either.
I don't think no. I've seen this one.
Oh, well. I will not spoil it. It is a phenomenal movie.
It's a tearjerker, though.
And it's very much a tearjerker. We used to, I used to have a friend that I worked with, and this was kind of our relationship. And then every time, I won't spoil it, but every time he would go into the office for like his review, he would come out like Jack Nicholson at the end. and so then I, being the kind friend, wanted to do the same thing that happens at the end of the movie.
So you would give him gum?
Well, not that scene. The other scene.
Spoil it.
There's other scenes.
Yeah. I would take him out on a fishing boat. Yes.
The Simpsons did a parody of this where...
Not where the guy thinks he's Michael Jackson?
Where something? Grandpa's in the nursing home.
Oh,
And they're going to go out anyway. So the Indian throws a drinking fountain through the window. but yeah, it's gum.
I was going to do that with the kitchen. With the, you know how they have the water bubblers and the water tanks? I figured that would be what I would do at the office. Another happy movie.
Another.
That's as Hugh Jackman. This is Real Steel, right? Where he does like the boxing robots. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Real Steel is a tearjerker.
Yeah.
Especially if you paid money to see it in the theater. It really...
I didn't like the way this movie ended.
That's why it's a tearjerker.
That's why it's a tearjerker, Juwan.
I have sad movies that I like. The way they ended. Like The Passion of the Christ. I like the way that ended.
This one, yeah, I was not expecting the ending of this one. I came to the party a little late on it, and I was just like, oh.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Watch one on an airplane.
It's yeah.
Like the worst time to watch it.
Yeah.
So,
was it called Million Dollar Baby?
Million Dollar Baby, yeah.
Yeah.
Million Dollar Baby. Jeff has it. Jeff has it.
Spoiler women shouldn't buy.
Clint Eastwood is missing, and yeah. He is correct.
It's like he's trying to tell him something, and he can't. Clint Eastwood in his later years, he's seeming like he can't hear anything.
What'd you say?
He doesn't understand.
Hey, is that a Christmas hat?
Wait, this is a boxy hat, right?
Oh, he looked and he was younger, too. It just, he can wear that look when he darker hair.
He had the same catchphrase as Lurch, too.
Go ahead. He said, now it's go ahead. What'd you say? Hey, all right. Please. So the next movie is this one.
Another good movie.
This one's
good. This one, right? If you get what's missing in this one, I will be thoroughly impressed.
What is it? What is this movie?
What's the movie, you guys? This is
Awakenings.
Awakenings, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a piano, is it? That's a real guess.
I thought it was like a ball. I thought it was like some sort of like, but I don't know why a ball would be shaped like that. So
what's the other? Oh, Patch Adams is the other one I'm thinking of.
That was what I was
very different.
Of. He looks too young.
Very different Robin Williams.
I was remembering the thing because at first Robin Williams is in a he's in a asylum, I guess you could say, or a mental institution, and they're doing group therapy. One of the guys has his hand up,
right?
And the guy's like, he's a question. He's like, he starts saying stuff like, "Who farted? How do you say hello to Hitler? How do you check an elephant for a hernia?" That kind of thing. The guy's hands up, and
anyway. This movie's a tearjerker.
This is Awakenings.
Yeah, it's Awakenings.
This movie, the first time I saw it, actually gave me some despair.
I know what it is. It's a glass of warm water. He's trying to see how
it will pee.
Nope.
How bad would that be if you're a doctor?
That was a little joke he used to like to play on the
sleeping patient. Catatonic. Just with the bed. The
nurse walks in. What are you doing? Isn't it hilarious?
You don't have to clean this up. Yes, I know. That makes it even better.
What a prank.
Robin Williams has the most hair on his knuckles of any actor that I've ever seen.
Wow.
Well, if you If you guessed typewriter and none of you did, then you would be correct. It is in fact
a stenographer, stenographone. What is that?
Stereograph, right?
If you if you do see that movie, just shut it off in the middle.
And... Oh, this is a Beached Whale. This is Free Willy 3. And it says the voyage home, and by home they mean
the voyage home. And he crosses the desert,
right?
In that movie,
this is the Rise of the Planet of the Apes.
The Rise of the Planet.
I figured that somebody would get this one. I didn't expect you to get the.
This is the door that Rose comes surfing in on after the Titanic has gone down. She's like,
And she's laughing and smiling, just having a good time. And Jack's frozen body's there.
Really dodged a bullet there.
She body surfs in, and it's not her body. It's one of the other frozen passengers. Nobody's got the... You know the movie? Does anybody know the movie?
I'm going to guess Beaches.
Nope.
Oh, Beaches was pretty sad, wasn't it? What's the one with the... Bette Midler singing "You're the Wind Beneath My Wings." Is that Beaches?
Yeah, it's Beaches.
Okay.
I'll tell you the movie. It's Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind.
Oh, I've never seen that.
Never seen it. All right.
Okay, then I'm guessing that that is... what's his name?
Well,
Jim Carrey?
Yeah,
anybody's name.
Be more specific.
Jim Carrey on a...
As the Grinch.
Yeah.
Jim Carrey as the Grinch.
On a surfboard.
Being buried alive up to the neck by the Whovilles, by the people of Whoville.
It's Kate Winslet, right? That's what made me think of Titanic.
Right. And Jim Carrey would be the obvious guess because there's only like two people in this movie. So
No, there's the doctor.
No, there's two people. That's it.
He is.
And lots of people on a train.
No.
He's carrying her, and he's riding a unicycle.
She's carrying
it's
him.
A piece of furniture.
It's a picnic. Picnic, and it's being ruined by fire ants.
I don't remember. It's been forever.
I guess nobody's seen this movie except for Mandy.
I haven't seen it. I know the situation, but
it is Jim Carrey on a bed.
Obviously. Oh yeah, okay. I can remember why now.
He's quite hallucinating at that point, I imagine.
Well, because he was tired. Okay.
Oh, I know what that is.
Famous movie, and this one is probably
The thing is that people will know is that that's actually a green box behind that green box. He's just holding a little green box.
And within the green box is the tooth of the inmate whose teeth he's punched out.
That would be awesome.
I wish I had thought of
a scene where there was a...
Wow,
he's
Jeff's
even got his name.
Jeff even knows the name. Yeah, old Mr.
I've never
James.
Seen that movie, actually. Still
you haven't seen
I have
Green
not.
Mile?
I know. No, I have not. Spoiler.
Do you know anything about it?
No.
Yes, he holds a mouse. Duh.
Exactly.
I didn't mean to ruin the ending. We really try not to ruin the ending for you, Brian.
No, this is actually an outtake. He never holds a mouse.
And it's a computer mouse.
Mr. Jingles. Yeah, well, I'm not going to say
anything. I won't do it.
I guarantee you that my...
there we go. That's Patch Adams. Clown nose.
Mm-hmm.
It's Mr. Jingles.
Wouldn't it be great if there was a mouse under there?
Oh, that'd be awesome.
It's a mouse.
Color or the same size as
Patch Adams was another movie that made me despair because I was not expecting that to turn out the way it did.
It's kind of like, well, I won't say it just in case it's one of the slides. There's a movie like, oh, this looks great, and then the movie you turn, and you're like, oh, why?
That actually looks like a tomato more than it looks like.
It does. That is a bulbous nose. I think there's one more. And this is going to be, Yeah, this is going to
go. Oh, yes.
Dead rabbit.
Yep, we know all about this one.
Peter Cottontail. Oh, really? You guys, we watched it once.
But why didn't you put in, if this is the last one, why don't you have the beginning of Up? Why don't you have the photo album?
Well, because it's a toss between the beginning of Up and the ending of this movie.
You have a 50%
chance. Not the beginning of Up, the end of Up, where he finds the last page of the photo album. Oh, you could block that out, and I would tell you what it said.
And it says,
"I cry.
Thanks for the adventure. Go make one of your own."
Thanks for the adventure. Go make one of your own.
I was gonna guess Woody, but it's also not Woody. Was the OG?
This is Woody. And that's the reason, the reason that this is it. I mean, you can't top this movie, or for just jerking tears. He's giving Woody to that little girl. He's passing his toys on to the little girl, and so he shows her how to play with Woody.
Hey, you know what? There's some movies like that thing about Finding Nemo.
Up was better.
I think it'd be better if the character was a mouse and then holding Tom Hanks in his hand, just kind of a turn around.
Have you seen either of them, Brian? Did you? Because you don't have kids. Did you see Toy Story?
Did see Toy Story, and I saw the third one, and I think the ending of the third one is. But the scene in the where they're all. In danger, I think. Was that three?
Yeah, that's the one where you're like,
that gets a little like, whoa, you're gonna do this to everybody? Okay.
Is Toy Story 3 the daycare one?
Yes.
They make you settle into, okay, I guess it's going down like this before they do anything about it. They let you, it's a good maybe 2 minutes.
Yeah, it's extremely long. Okay, it's like the last half of the movie is just a conveyor belt towards the fire or whatever. Yeah.
But like scenes like this, though, like when I watched Finding Nemo the first time, it was before kids. I was like, oh, that was a cool movie.
Right.
And then after my son's like two, he's two and he likes Finding Nemo, so we start watching it. And when he rescues him at the end and he flashes back to when he was an egg, you know, he's like, it's okay, daddy's got you. I was like, what? This didn't happen before.
But I have not seen Up.
I think you haven't seen Up either.
I have watch not. It. Oh, Brian. It's good.
Up is worth it. You don't need to have kids to watch Up.
All you got to you just watch the first 5 minutes of Up. There's not even any talking in it, and it's just.
Yes, because that's what I like. I'm feeling good today. What do I want to do? You know, I want to feel miserable. All right,
that's my problem.
I watched the beginning of Up, the end of Toy Story, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, and somewhere we'll put Marley and Me in there, and we'll
Well, the end of Toy Story 3 was the thing. I think I've told you about me and Dave Pendleton. Sitting at a truck stop eating lunch, and I don't even remember how it came up, but we were talking about movies that we saw that we enjoyed, and back and forth, and he said, well, like Toy Story 3, have you seen that? And I go, yeah. And I said, the ending of that, and he goes, uh-huh. And then we both looked down at
silence.
So we're sitting there sobbing in a truck stop
while the semis are going by.
I'm trying to think of like which is the saddest movie as far as
of all time
of those.
Oh, okay, because like
of the Pixar,
like Notebook's pretty bad too. Notebook'll.
I'll tell you, Dad hasn't seen the Notebook. The shorts, the Pixar shorts. Has anybody seen? Partly Sunny?
Clouds. About the clouds.
Yes. The one where the clouds are making babies for the storks to deliver. Have you seen this, Juan?
I think so.
Do you
remember what movie it was on before?
No.
The one stork keeps getting all the dangerous little animals.
Right. There's one storm cloud that like keeps building all of these really vicious animals for his stork. And so all the so the stork keeps looking longingly at the, like, fluffy white clouds that are making ducklings and, you know, all these
little squirrels
cute kittens
and
puppies and stuff. And, like, he comes.
He gets porcupines and electric eels.
There's one where, like, the cloud builds this little, you know, fluffy looking sheep thing, but then he zaps it to bring it to life, and the stork is holding it in his hands, and it turns out it wasn't a sheep, it was a porcupine. And he's like, and so, it looked like a sheep when it was in cloud form, and then he's
there's like a little goat. There's a little goat, and the stork is kind of excited at first because he's like, oh, it's a cute little goat, but it turns out it's like a mountain goat.
It's
and
a
it
ram.
Just butts him. It just
yeah, it like hits him right in the stomach. So, like, every time he comes back, he's like beaten, he's losing feathers and he's stressed out, and so eventually the stork leaves and flies away to one of the other clouds, and it makes the storm cloud cry, and he storms and he's angry at first, but then he just starts crying, and the stork is asking for something from the other cloud, and so the cloud is building him something, and storm cloud is all upset, but then the stork comes back, and the thing the other cloud had made was a helmet. And so he put his helmet on.
So then he puts the helmet on and goes.
And he's like.
And then you know, it's kind of like the end of Lord of the Rings for me. There's a couple scene. He was like, you know, my friends, you bow to no one. It's a little bit like, nope, they don't. They sure don't.
Not those guys.
You bow to no man. Stand up, Frodo.
Frodo gets on the boat with the
exactly animal. That too. That yeah. Well, that we cut off. We go, okay, well, that's it. They destroyed the ring, everybody. Okay.
Yeah. Right.
Good movie.
There's not much else after that.
Bye.
We went home.
Bye, movie.
Mm. All right. That's our tear jerking show. For this Christmas, Adam.
Go get some water. Rehydrate, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Thank you so much. And we hope everybody has an excellent Christmas.
Mm-hmm. Merry even.
Merry Christmas.
There's no effort party tonight, folks.
There's no effort party tonight.
Yeah, we need to recover. We're all very sad. And so we just need to take the night off. Should we do credits?
I got an idea.
I don't know how to do the credits.
Like we're all old women recognizing the names and
like the Chevy
slowly
commercial.
Becoming cognizant.
Right, like we're in the truck. Oh, I'll do the sound of the truck.
That is awful. Oh gosh.
Oh, look over there, the comedy click. That's where you met JT Oaks.
There's David Brennan.
Oh, a donation duck.
Brenda Erickson.
Oh, Ken Corsten. I dated him in middle school.
I went to school with R.J. Osmond.
Donna Roos was so mean to me.
Hey,
it's who's John driving Unger. This truck?
I remember. Everything.
Bye.
Now. Thank you.
And so, from all of us, the Starving Comics Quarantine Show, to all of you out there in internet land, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.